Welcome to World Action and Reaction News. Today's news snaps are: apart from raising tensions between India and China, the Doklam standoff could potentially threaten Beijing's Belt and Road Initiative, BRI. Chinese scholars and experts have warned for the first time. Macau-based military expert Antony Wong Dong has cautioned that Beijing's hardball politics are pushing New Delhi further away and could end up making it an enemy. China is playing psychological warfare, but it should realize that even if it defeated India in a war on land, it would be impossible for the PLA Navy to break India's maritime containment, Wong told Hong Kong-based English daily South China Morning Post, SCMP, pointing to the importance of the Indian Ocean as a commercial lifeline.
India is allowed to construct hydroelectric power facilities on tributaries of the Jhelum and Chenab rivers with certain restrictions under the 1960 Indus Waters Treaty, IWT, the World Bank has said. The World Bank's comments came as officials from India-Pakistan concluded the secretary-level talks over the IWT. Pakistan opposes the construction of the Kishanganga, 330 megawatts, and Ratle, 850 megawatts, hydroelectric power plants being built by India in Jammu and Kashmir, the global lender said in a fact sheet issued yesterday. Noting that the two countries disagree over whether the technical design features of the two hydroelectric plants contravene the treaty, the World Bank said the IWT designates these two rivers as well as the Indus as the western rivers to which Pakistan has unrestricted use. Among other uses, India is permitted to construct hydroelectric power facilities on these rivers subject to constraints specified in annexures to the treaty, the bank said in its fact sheet. It noted that the talks on the technical issues of the IWT took place this week in a spirit of goodwill and cooperation.
ISRO used the SCATSAT-1 to track flooding across the nation during the monsoon, with a special focus on Gujarat and Rajasthan. Monsoon activity in West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Assam, and Bihar were also tracked. The satellite used data based on backscattering and brightness temperatures of the Earth to monitor the flood situations. ISRO was able to capture a high-resolution data set by scanning overlapping areas with the satellite. The backscattering and brightness data were combined to figure out which regions were inundated and which regions were only partially submerged. The satellite was also used to figure out the wetness of the soil in the affected areas, on how saturated or dry the regions were. Floods along the Brahmaputra and the Ganga were tracked using this method. In Gujarat, extreme floods were observed in the districts of Ahmedabad, Mersana, Kedah, Banskantha, Baunagar, but Bharuch was relatively dry.
China formally opened its first military base on the Indian Ocean littoral in the small but strategic African country of Djibouti. Outwardly, there is no reason for New Delhi to be overly excited by this lone event. Beijing had announced its plans to set up a base there a few years ago, and the ships carrying the first batch of base personnel left China last month. Djibouti rents portions of its territory to foreign countries as a revenue model. France, the United States and Japan have military bases there. China has described the base as a logistics facility and that it would be used to support anti-piracy and humanitarian missions in the Horn of Africa. This is not without basis. China has been an active participant in fighting Somali pirates. It has begun deploying blue-helmeted peacekeepers in places like South Sudan.
Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, will launch its navigation satellite IRNSS-1H by the end of this month to augment the existing 7 satellites of NAVIC constellation, a senior ISRO official said. To be launched on board PSLV-C-39. IRNSS-1H will be a backup navigation satellite for IRNSS-1A, one among the 7 satellites in the constellation, as its 3 rubidium atomic clocks on board had stopped functioning. IRNSS-1H on board PSLV-C-39 will be launched by the end of this month. The exact date will be decided shortly, a senior ISRO official told PTI. He said IRNSS-1H will be a backup for IRNSS-1A, whose 3 imported atomic clocks had failed. The Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System, IRNSS, is an independent regional navigation satellite system developed by India on PAR with US-based GPS. The system that offers services like terrestrial and marine navigation, disaster management, vehicle tracking and fleet management, navigation aid for hikers and travelers, visual and voice navigation for drivers, was named as NAVIC, Navigation with Indian Constellation, by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. ISRO had launched 7 satellites IRNSS-1G on April 28, 2016, IRNSS-1F, March 10, 2016, IRNSS-1E, January 20, 2016, IRNSS-1D, March 28, 2015, IRNSS-1C, October 16, 2014, IRNSS-1B, April 4, 2014, and IRNSS-1A on July 1, 2013. According to ISRO officials, the total cost of all the 7 satellites was Rs 1,420 crore.
The U.S. Air Force is about to buy 2 mothballed Boeing 747s that were abandoned by a bankrupt Russian airline and convert these into the next Air Force One, a source said. The sale could save the Air Force millions of dollars, and comes after then-President-elect Donald Trump said in December that the Air Force One replacement project costs were ridiculous. Speaking on condition of anonymity, a source close to the deal yesterday told AFP that Boeing is set to sell a pair of 747-8 jetliners to the Air Force. Air Force One is actually 2 planes, one for the president and a spare.
With the National Investigation Agency, NIA, stating that Devinder Singh Bell, a close aide of Hurriyat leader Syed Ali Shah Gilani, was allegedly in touch with Islamabad, outgoing Pakistan High Commissioner Abdul Basit on Tuesday stated that he had no idea who the former was, adding that India has made such allegations in the past without any proof. Speaking to Ani here, Basit said, "I have never heard the name of this man. First, we have to understand that this is not a new problem. Jammu and Kashmir is an old issue since Pakistan got independence. So that problem has been there. Both the countries, people of Jammu and Kashmir have been struggling for their right to self-determination. The fact of the matter is their struggle is justified, legitimate, under Universal Declaration of Human Rights."
The Indian Army is all set to conduct joint exercises with 2 Southeast Asian countries, Myanmar and Maldives, in the coming months, a top army officer told TOI on Tuesday. The exercises will either be conducted in Pune or in Belgaum in the coming months. The location is yet to be finalized, the officer said. The exercises will provide opportunity to foster joint manship and interoperability between the defense forces of the countries, the army officer added.
A total of 37 defense aircraft and helicopters have crashed since May 2014, in which 55 people were killed, the government told the Rajya Sabha on Tuesday. According to details provided by the Minister of State for Defense, the armed forces lost 25 aircraft and 12 helicopters during the period. Out of the total, the Indian Air Force lost 24 aircraft and 5 helicopters in crashes since 2014-15, and main reasons for the accidents were human error and technical defect. 37 fighters and defense aircraft have crashed during the last 3 years, Subhash Bamra said in a written response to a question. He said every accident is thoroughly investigated by a court of inquiry and its recommendations are implemented.
Aerospace company and manufacturer Boeing and Tata Advanced Systems Limited, TASL, a wholly owned subsidiary of Tata Sons focused on providing integrated solutions for aerospace, defense, and homeland security, announced delivery of the first crown and tail cone assembly for the Indian configuration of the CH-47F Chinook heavy lift helicopter. Manufactured by Tata Advanced Systems Limited in Hyderabad, the parts will be delivered to Boeing for final assembly of the 15 helicopters scheduled for delivery to the Indian Air Force. In 2015, India's Ministry of Defence finalized an order with Boeing for the production, training, and support of 15 CH-47F Chinook helicopters to enhance India's capabilities across a range of military and humanitarian missions. Deliveries are scheduled to begin in 2019. This delivery is another significant step in our journey to increase defense capability and manufacturing capacity out of India with our strategic partners, said Boeing India President Pratyush Kumar, in a release statement. Tata Advanced Systems has demonstrated its ability to deliver high-quality components to the CH-47 Chinook program on schedule, which in turn helps Boeing meet commitments to our customers. We are clearly invested in leveraging the full potential of capability that exists in India to continue delivering greater value for less cost to our US and international customers.
Finance Minister Arun Jaitley on Tuesday said ordnance factories are not being privatized, but added that these defense manufacturing units should not be sewing clothes either. Ordnance factories should focus on ammunition manufacturing, they should not be sewing clothes and tailoring, Jaitley said on Tuesday while replying to a discussion on supplementary demand for grants. We are not going to privatize ordnance factories, he added.
The coastal security issues are regularly reviewed at appropriate levels with National Committee on Strengthening Maritime and Coastal Security, NCSMCS, being the apex body for interministerial and interagency coordination. A coastal security mechanism in the form of a three-tiered cover comprising Indian Navy, IN, Indian Coast Guard, ICG, and State Marine Police with demarcated areas of responsibility has been put in place. Coastal security exercises are being conducted in all coastal states and union territories to assess the effectiveness of existing mechanisms and to address gaps. Coastal Surveillance Network, CSN, which includes radars, has been established along the coastline. Under Phase I of this project, 45 radars have been made operational. Indian Navy and Indian Coast Guard have been provided with adequate powers under the Coast Guard Act, 1978 and other acts/rules to enable them to face various challenges effectively.
For decades, the U.S. aircraft carrier fleet has been hurling planes into the sky with the aid of steam. However, a new generation of ships are about to launch with the Electromagnetic Aircraft Launch System, EMALS. It's been tested with weights and unmanned drones, but for the first time, a real fighter jet has been launched by the EMALS system on the USS Gerald R. Ford. The catapults used on most aircraft carriers divert steam from the ship's nuclear reactor to operate the system. This is a quick and dirty way to generate the mechanical power necessary to accelerate a 30,000-pound plane to about 170 miles per hour across just a few hundred feet of runway. The only viable alternatives thus far have been shorter, ramped runways.
Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.